What up, people? Welcome to my channel. This is new to my journey, and I'm super, super, super pumped to share my process, my paintings, my artwork, and all in between of what goes on in here. Today, I am doing a study of a portrait, and because sometimes I get too bored of just doing a face, I wanted to implement something with nature and combining them, meshing them into one. And this was a 2-day process. In my head, I wanted to do something that was a 1-day session, but starting off a little bit slower, that's okay. I don't have a name for this painting yet, but for now, it's gonna be called Beetle Face. I've always had a fascination with beetles growing up. I used to collect them when I was outside at recess. I would get a little sand bucket. I lived in Florida as a kid, but I would get a little bucket and I would capture a beetle, but then I would grab leaves. I would make a little environment for this beetle and just watch it during recess. And then when time was out, I would just release it back into the wild. So I always had a fascination with bugs. There's really awesome colors. There's some pretty extravagant looking insects. So today I am doing a beetle study as well as a portrait study. And I want to show you how I combine those. This is the process that went behind it, and I really hope you guys enjoy. So let's jump right in. So I picked a beetle reference from online and I really loved this one. And then I also picked a portrait reference and I did a little bit of editing in Photoshop and kind of messed with the colors and decided I really liked the portrait to be green and the beetle to be pink. I believe it gave me more of like a nature vibe. So I started getting my base colors ready. I wanted to get browns and blues and possibly just maybe get my green started. So I started to paint the background. I don't like to paint on just a plain white canvas, and started putting in the contour. I did a loose painted sketch. I was just orienting where the eyes and the nose and lips would be. Even though I was gonna cover her face, this was gonna help me know where to put the beetle and go by the reference photo. I started to fill in some of her hair with blue. I came up with the idea to make it kind of like a sky color, and I enjoyed getting to paint the beetle quick and really wanted to get it on there so that way I wasn't overdoing the face. The beetle had a lot of colors. It had pinks, blues, purples. So I started by putting the base layer on. Then I started to put on highlights. I usually like to work dark to light. I don't know if other artists do this, but it helps me learn where I need to put the highlights after I get the base color on. And I started to work on her eyes. The eyes are some of the most important part of this painting, so I made sure to
get excited and start that first. I really enjoyed painting on the Beetle because of how many colors there were. There were greens, navy, aquas, and I started splotching some different areas just to kind of understand where the color was. Then I started to blend a little bit and add highlights here and there just so it can really capture that shiny, hard surface of the Beetle. I left the neck for last. This is probably because I know the neck is really hard. So since I went with the sky color, I got excited to make her afro the clouds, and I wanted to do a little bit of a night and day vibe on her hair. It really captured the rain and sunlight that I had in the process of this video. And I wanted to do a lavender background, kind of similar to a sunset, but I felt that it also matched the Beetle really well. Doing these collarbones was not easy, I'll be honest. This was frustrating, but with a little bit of patience, I was able to get most of the base color down. And once I really liked her skin tone and was able to capture her skin tone, then it made it easier to understand where the highlights were on that clavicle bone and where the light was hitting her on her shoulders. It's definitely more of a frontal light angle, so it was cool. I really enjoyed that the perspective of light was kind of frontal. And last, once everything was painted in, then I gave this Beetle its legs so that way it could run around on my woman's face.
That's a wrap. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really enjoyed making this painting. I definitely had a lot of lessons along the way, and if it inspired you to make a new painting, then I did my job. So anyways, I love you guys, and thank you so much for tuning in. There are more painting videos to come, possibly more speed paintings, live paintings, artist tips, and all of that good stuff. So again, thank you guys so much for watching. Hit the like and share button. If you want to drop a comment of what you thought about the painting, it would mean a lot to me. And I'm going to continue to keep them rolling. I'm going to continue to make these paintings, okay? So I'll see y'all very soon. Much love, much blessings. Peace. Oh, I stapled it to the wrong side. Now I'm inside the cloud.